Hey guys, welcome back to Vibrations and Libations. I'm James.
And I'm Keith.
And tonight, we're listening to Willie Nelson and his family live.
That's right.
On this two record set right here. This was recorded back in 78, you said?
1978.
All right. And this, if you are a Willie Nelson fan and don't have this album, you have got to get this album. The next time I see it, I'm buying it. I've been listening to it. Keith suggested that we do it. I actually don't have the album, but the first time I see it, it's going to be mine. This is a classic live album right here.
My sister-in-law gave it to me.
Of course.
Nice.
Everyone who knows me, and they all say, well, Keith doesn't like country music. Keith doesn't like country music. Well, that may be true. I like good music, and this is good music. Yeah. Whether you call it country, rock, or whatever. There's not much difference in this and some of the rock I listen to.
Sure.
And it's bluesy and everything else. But I don't like pop country. I don't like new country.
Right.
It all is just pure shit.
Yes.
So, I don't even consider it music. I just consider it garbage. I don't even consider it.
Yeah.
So when people say Keith doesn't like country music, here's proof positive with this one, because I think my rating on this album will show that Keith does actually like some country music.
Right. And there used to be a day when this album come out to where you could change a radio station from a country station to a rock station and you could tell the difference immediately.
Right.
You can't do that anymore.
Certain rock stations.
Well, okay. I'll give you that. Yeah, certain rock stations. But, as far as country music goes today, I'm sure everything needs to evolve, but the country music, like you said, it's shit.
But I think that you could probably, a country station, pop country station, and a pop music station, I think you couldn't change back and forth between them, because country doesn't sound like rock. It sounds more like rap to me.
Yeah.
And some of them are like rap. It's horrible.
And I think that's referred to sometimes as tractor rap. I've heard that phrase before.
Fantastic.
It's just great.
We've devoted enough time to that.
We have. Okay.
What are we drinking?
Tonight we're drinking some Weller Special Reserve. And you can see here, Keith is providing this for us tonight. And he's already been hitting this kind of hard. Not tonight.
Right. Not tonight.
But in the recent past, he's definitely sampled this.
Right, and you have told me that Weller's good. I've been trying to broaden my horizons, drink a little more bourbon, try it. And in my bourbon adventures, most of them just taste like wood. And, there are ones that I think are good. And by good, I mean they taste like wood and they're smooth enough that I can sit and sip on them straight, with a little bit of water or ice mixed in with them. And, I just haven't really thought it was that interesting, but still, I was interested enough to keep exploring.
Yeah.
Well, a friend of mine we mentioned before, the McDonald boys, they said, hey, we got a line on some Weller, do you want a bottle? And I was like, hell yeah, and they got it. Man, from the time I tried this, I got to put on the brakes
because
I got to save it for an episode.
It is.
It was hard. It's hard to stop because it's good.
Yeah.
It's very tasty. Everything everybody told me about it is true. It is really good.
It's been maybe 3 or 4 years ago I was able to get a bottle of Weller 12-year-old, and I only paid like $24 for it. It wasn't very expensive at all. And that was, that was the best stuff I thought I had ever had. And with the surge in bourbon popularity, maybe started by the whole Pappy Van Winkle craze, I don't know, but bourbon's gotten a lot more popular here in the past couple of years, and this stuff is hard to find. The last time I bought a bottle of it, I had to go to the customer service desk at the liquor store that I go to, and had to ask to see if they had it. And the only reason I did that was because one of the guys stocking the shelf said, hey, if you want some Weller, you better go get it, because we only have one case and it's been selling pretty quick. So they were keeping it behind the counter, hid. So if you didn't have the heads up on it, you didn't even know it was there. And still, with it being that popular and people looking for it, it's still reasonably priced.
That's a tribute to the makers of mm-hmm. it, that they haven't taken advantage of the supply demand yeah. kind of thing. They want to keep the price the same, and they do the same thing that I've heard with Pappy Van Winkle. You know, it's pretty pricey
yeah, right.
anyway, but people are gouging, you know, charging $800,000 a bottle and things yeah. like that, you know, and if they find out about it, if it's a liquor store or whatever, they're coming after you.
Right.
Gouging people.
Yeah, that really sucks, but the Weller it's made by the same people who make Buffalo Trace and Pappy Van Winkle, correct? Yeah.
And I believe the Pappy Van Winkle is, this Weller, by the way, is a wheated whiskey.
Mm-hmm.
They take the rye out and they put whiskey instead. And same as Pappy Van Winkle, and I believe it's just the same recipe. Pappy Van Winkle's just aged longer.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So if you've never had Pappy Van Winkle and you're just dying to try it, and you are lucky enough to find a bottle of Weller, try that, because it's, you know, Pappy Van Winkle before Pappy Van Winkle.
Right.
It's the same stuff.
It's Baby Van Winkle.
Baby, I like that. Baby Van Winkle. Yeah. That might have to be the name of the video.
Yeah,
Baby Van Winkle.
Maybe.
All right, so I'm going to go
second
ahead and pour some.
In
yeah,
a row.
Man, you're coming up. You have to copyright some of this stuff, man.
Man, maybe I need a new job.
All right, so I'm going to get a little snort of this here. I appreciate you sharing this with me tonight, Keith.
Oh, yeah.
So the first thing I notice whenever I drink this is, you know, you got to get the good smell going on there. And it's a good, smooth drink, and it's a good, smooth smell also. It doesn't give you that burn in your nose when you smell it. Like, even, you know, some good bourbons do. My favorite bourbon right now is probably the Eagle Rare that
yeah.
we did a few videos ago. I really like that bourbon, but it's smooth. It's got a, you know, complex flavor going on there, but it's still got a little bit of a burn to me compared to this.
Right. And this, you know, it's described on their website as having a sweet nose with the presence of caramel and tasting notes of honey, butterscotch, mm-hmm. and a soft woodiness.
Yeah.
And I agree with all of that, because when you smell it, it like you said, it's a lot more smooth than other bourbons,
mm-hmm.
and you know, it doesn't make you want to cringe or anything when you smell it, because it's not burning, but you can smell that little hint of sweetness, and when you taste it there's that, the finish is just sweet
yeah.
and interesting, and the wood is mild.
Mm-hmm.
The wood flavor, it's just good. It's the most interesting bourbon that I've tried so far.
Yeah. One of my favorite things about drinking bourbon, period, is not necessarily the flavor of it in my mouth, but after I've swallowed it, the flavor that it leaves behind on
right.
your tongue, and it hits your tongue in different spots.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm not an aficionado on bourbon by any means, but you know, you instead of just gulping it down and drinking it as quick as you can to get drunk, you know, try to get some bourbon and enjoy it and take a sip of it, and then pay attention to what's going on your tongue after you've, you know, swallowed that sip, and you may appreciate bourbon more if you do that.
Yeah, it's like when you breathe in, you can just, when that hair hits all those areas of your tongue,
mm-hmm.
you can taste different things. Like on the tip, it's a little bit hot, but on
yeah.
the back, it's sweet. That's why, you know,
yeah.
the finish, it's just a sweet taste, almost left behind.
Yeah. Now, I'm not sure how Keith is drinking his. I'm drinking mine with one ice cube, and I like to do that just to, you know, kind of, you know, make it a little bit cold. And the water, I think, does kind of separate that taste profile out, too.
It brightens it up a little bit. It,
mm-hmm.
it allows you, I don't know, I guess it takes some of that heat out of it to where you're not just tasting that hot bourbon
yeah.
flavor there, but it kind of separates all the notes out.
Mm-hmm.
Getting a little bit of water in there.
All right, so we got the Weller. And listening to the Willie Nelson here, I mean, what a treasure.
Weller and Willie.
Yeah. What a great performer for so many years. Still going strong today. I have a friend who just saw him, I think, earlier this year in Owensboro, Kentucky. Maybe it was last year. I can't remember the date on it, but I just saw him recently. And he said it was a great show. You know, I mean, the guy's still going strong, just, you know, touring probably till the day he dies. I don't know, but I have not been able to see him live, and that's something I do want to do.
Well, he's a busy man. He's got his touring, and he's got his weed company now, and all that, you know?
Right.
I believe he even has a whiskey.
Oh, I did not know that.
I believe he does.
We may have to try that one, right?
We have to.
So, this is what I would consider the late 70s, early 80s era of country music. I guess the highlight of outlaw country, where you had, you got Merle Haggard, you had Waylon Jennings, you had Willie Nelson, of course, Johnny Paycheck, who is featured on this album. He actually does Take This Job and Shove It on this live album. And this is stuff I remember listening to with my dad whenever he would listen to music. It was, you know, all those country guys like that. He wasn't a big rock fan. He was more of a country listener. And listening to this album, it just brought back so many memories. You know, those songs, Whiskey River, my favorite song on this album.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's just packed with classics. Classic Willie Nelson songs from that, you know, that golden age of outlaw country, as it's coined. Do you have a list of other songs that are on it?
I'm not naming the songs because
there's like 30-some songs.
There's 33 songs on this thing.
Yeah.
And here's the important part for you, James.
Okay.
It starts with Whiskey River.
Yes.
And then the next to last song is Whiskey River, and it just kind of flows into the last song, which is, let me get that. The Only Daddy That Will Walk the Line.
And if I remember correctly, that was covered at the Brotherhood concert. Is that correct?
That is correct.
That we went to last year.
Yeah.
So, and I didn't know that song before then. You know, before the Brotherhood concert. And then whenever I was listening to this album, I saw that it was on here. And I was like, hey, I know that song.
Yeah.
I realize what's going on now. So, kind of opened my eyes up a little bit to that. So. But it's got, I'm going to name off some of the other songs on here. Woo! If I can do it without the album cover. Okay, so we've got Whiskey River, Stay a Little Longer, which is an awesome, awesome song. Crazy, which is a Patsy Cline song, but Willie Nelson actually wrote that song.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else we got? Mama, Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up to Be Cowboys. If that's not a classic country song, I don't know what is. That is the quintessential outlaw country song there. Good-hearted Woman. Let's see what's, and then the Redhead Stranger medley, which if you've never listened to the Redhead Stranger album from Willie Nelson, that is that's a classic Willie Nelson album right there. You gotta listen to that. It's awesome. So maybe I can put this back up here without dropping.
Careful.
Hey, I did it. Hey, nice.
Good
nice,
boy,
nice.
James.
Thank you. Cheers to that one. All right. Okay. So what else you got to share, Keith?
All right. This was recorded in 1978, as we said. It's a double LP. There's two albums there.
Yep.
It was recorded live at Harrah's in Lake Tahoe, Nevada.
A casino, I guess. Harrah's,
right,
the casino.
Right,
okay.
Right,
okay.
Right. And it was in the height of Willie Madness.
I'm noticing he doesn't have his long hair and braids here in this.
Right.
It's kind of the start of it, you know?
I guess so.
Yeah.
And then it's important to note that Emmylou Harris is on here for a couple songs.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, you already said Johnny Paycheck. He sings on a couple songs as well. And this album, when it was released, it was on the U.S. Billboard Top Country Albums. It made it to number one. And then on the U.S. Billboard 200, it made it to number 32.
Hmm.
So there's all the trivia I have for you today, ladies and gentlemen.
So, you know, pretty popular country music album there. You know, I kind of have to go back a little bit. Maybe I'll end up editing this out. I don't know. But there's been a small resurgence, I guess I'd have to say, in this type of country music, the classic, like I said earlier, outlaw country type of music, with Sturgill Simpson releases that he's come out with. So Sturgill Simpson is a great artist from Kentucky. And there's been a few other guys, Chris Stapleton's in there. He's kind of broke through to the poppy kind of side of it a little bit, but you know, still it's good music. If you want to listen to some good classic stuff, listen to some Willie. And then I would also throw out a name here that maybe some of you know or maybe you don't know. A guy called named Towns Van Zandt. And he actually wrote the song Poncho and Lefty Willie Nelson and Merle Haggard do together. So that's a cover of a Towns Van Zandt song. And you know, you can look him up on YouTube or on Pandora or anything. Towns Van Zandt is his name. And the classic kind of Texas troubadour going around, you know, he just got his guitar and just singing his freaking heart out. I would call him probably the Bob Dylan of country music.
Oh yeah.
With he's got great songwriting, great lyrics, and I mean just really good moving music in my opinion. So, and I think him and Willie were friends during that time before Towns Van Zandt passed away. And I think they're actually both have famous performances on Austin City Limits.
Yeah.
Which is a great show.
Great show.
And
great performances.
Yeah, I've discovered a lot of groups on there that I had never heard of before. And they don't just do country music. I mean, they do good, popular, I won't say popular. They do a lot of good music.
Yeah.
Foo Fighters have been on there. I think maybe Pearl Jam's been on there.
Yeah.
A band kind of little known, I guess, that I like called the Polyphonic Spree. They've been on there. Oak Crow Medicine Show have been on there. So they feature a wide variety of music.
Right.
Not just country music being, you know, Austin, Texas. Okay, so anyway. What now? Whiskey? Music? What are we talking about?
Let's rate.
Let's do it.
Let's do the ratings.
Let me finish this off. You go ahead.
Okay. So, first, I want to rate the... We were talking about the album. Let's rate the album.
Okay.
So, I'm going to give this album a 4 out of 5.
Okay.
I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5. It would have got a 5 out of 5 if it weren't for side 3. Side 3, there's a few gospel songs on there, and it just rips me out of it. And
right.
I don't care for them. I don't care. They're really traditional. I grew up Baptist in the church, and I hated those songs then, and I hate them now. Nothing against religion or church or anything like that. I mean, I've converted to Catholicism and go to Catholic church, but you know, don't mean I have to like the music. It's bad.
Right, right. I will agree with you 100% on the rating and for the reason of the rating. So I give it a 4 out of 5 also. The gospel songs... It throws the whole album out of sync, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Just because you've got, for the most part, a really good upbeat tempo going.
Right.
And then the gospel music comes in. And I'll even say that they're not bad songs. But the way that they're played, it just kind of just throws a monkey wrench in the whole thing.
It's like you got a great big ship anchor. And you're on a speedboat going as fast as you can. You're all planed out. And you throw that anchor overboard.
I like that.
And it just, like, drags you way down. Yeah, it's like what
that.
The hell happened? We were, like, going balls out.
Yeah, yeah.
But,
now, maybe if they were done a little bit upbeat, you know, along with the rest of the album, I would maybe like that a little bit better. But
maybe they could borrow that Christian rock song from Master of Reality. Black Sabbath.
Black Sabbath, yeah. And, throw that in there, Willie.
Yeah, Willie can cover that one. I'll listen to that all day long.
Yeah. So we both agree 4 out of 5 on the album. So I'll go ahead and rate the bourbon first.
Go ahead.
I'm giving it a 5 out of 5, and if we rated the 6, I'd probably just go ahead and give it a 7. It's that good. And for the price, you cannot beat it. For the price, it is probably the best bourbon out there. I don't know how much this bottle was. Probably $30 range, maybe?
No, it was...
Not even.
After tax and everything, $23.
Oh, man, yeah, you can't... Yeah. You can't beat that.
$23. Rite Aid. Rite Aid.
Nice.
Yeah.
I never thought about going there and looking.
Yeah, I mean, that's not where I got it at all.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay.
I didn't say which Rite Aid.
But, yeah, I give it a 5 out of 5. This is, for the price... And when you find it, you know, 9 times out of 10, if I've seen it on a shelf, it's been on the lower shelf.
Yeah.
You know, it's not been up on the top shelf, and it's not even been on the second shelf. It's been down low, along with the you know the very old bourbon and the you know all the what I would call junk bourbon. You know, the just brown rubbing alcohol is what I would call it for the most part. But if you can find it, get it and try it. I think you'll like it.
And I believe it's won some awards. This year it's won 2 awards in California. It like won a gold medal for some bourbon festival, bourbon something there. And then and also in California won like the silver medal award for something else. I can't remember what it was. I should have wrote that down, but I didn't. But anyway, I agree with James 100%. 5 out of 5 stars.
Nice.
I've never tried a better bourbon in my entire life.
Yeah.
In my short,
short
bourbon connoisseur life. But it's definitely a good one, and it's going to be hard to beat. I think this is going to end up being my favorite. If I ever taste, you know, Pappy Van Winkle, I really want to taste it bad. You know, I think Jay's Liquors in town, they have a bourbon bar there. You can buy it by the, you know,
the shot or whatever, by the drink.
Or by the drink. And so maybe I'll go in there and get a $20 drink.
Gosh. Yeah, that's.
I don't know.
Maybe that's a good deal.
Maybe we'll go in halvesies on a glass.
We'll get little straws, little mixing straws, and just kind of take turns drinking out of it. All right, so you rate it 5 out of 5 then?
5 out of 5.
All right, so Willie is the best stuff to drink, the best music to drink bourbon too, I think. You know, he's got some moody stuff, he's got some upbeat stuff, feel good stuff, but either way, you know, some Willie and some whiskey, bourbon, whatever you want to call it, you just can't go wrong. It just fits together. And this song is so awesome right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, that's awesome. Take back the weed, take back the cocaine, baby.
Right.
Man, it's a great song. Willie, you're the master, man. There's nobody beats you, I don't think. Nobody beats you. All right, so have we got anything else?
I think that's it.
All right, man, so we've rated the album, we've rated the drink, so don't forget to like and comment down below. If you're not a subscriber, please go ahead and subscribe. Click that button, and there's a little bell there on the side too. Click that bell, that way when we post stuff, you get notifications on that we've put something new up. So we would appreciate all the support that we can get from you guys. And if that's it,
go check us out on Twitter. We've only got like 6 Twitter followers, man.
Oh, really? We need some more of those too.
It's pretty sad. We're pretty solid on Instagram. We're pretty solid on Facebook. And, you know, YouTube is always, but
it is what it is.
Our Twitter
sucks. Yeah. All right. So go to Twitter and follow us on Twitter. All right. So for Vibrations and Libations and Willie and some Weller, I'm James.
And I'm Keith.
And thanks a lot, guys, for watching. We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye. We're going to drink the rest of this shit.
All right.
It seems like they didn't even enjoy making that album to me.